Hey, it's been too long here, man.
Yes.
So, as I said, we got a couple hours before the trade deadline. What are the rumors? What are you hearing about the trade?
What am I hearing? I'm not hearing anything. I'm just saying, you know what? I told the Lakers a long time ago, if you trade my son, it'd be the worst thing you ever did. And I guarantee they trade my son, they will never get a championship. Because what they're trying to do is be the one-hitter quitter, trying to get all these players, okay, thinking you're going to win a championship.
You trying to speak that in existence.
No, I'm just trying to tell you. They trying to do it like this, where they getting all these players. They ain't the players, the coach. You don't have the coach, you out of luck. So you can get as many players as you want. If you don't have a system or you don't understand what you're getting ready to do, you're not going to win. I don't care. You can get everybody that's good.
So you're saying LeBron James without Lonzo cannot win a championship in Los Angeles?
LeBron James without Lonzo is not going to win a championship in L.A. I guarantee that.
Lavar, you understand. I understand. Skip and I can criticize a coach or a player or blah, blah, blah. But we don't have a son currently on that team or currently playing. You understand how people look at that like, come on, Lavar.
You think I care how people look at
me? I know you don't care, but I'm saying.
I'm going to keep doing what I do. They can't do nothing about it.
No, it's not.
You know what? This situation about to get hot. I'm going to pass y'all out some water. Because this is big boiling water.
Okay, what's special about this water?
I'm going to tell you something special that's better. You ain't going to never, ever see an African-American on the water, but that show looked like Lonzo Ball.
What's special about it? I don't care what's on it. What skin it? What's going to make it better? What's
zero nitrates. You know what that means? That's the purest water you can get. Untouched by human hand. Come straight from the board right into the bottle.
This ain't come out your
faucet. This ain't no purification.
This ain't come out your faucet.
No, straight from Lithuania.
I was just going to say.
Underwater.
Lithuania.
It's imported water.
You were busy.
You drink this, I guarantee you, 20 more years.
Really?
Look how it tastes. Wow. It slithered down your throat. You didn't know it was water.
Wait, I want to taste like water.
Will it make Shannon bigger? I want to know.
It'll make Shannon healthier. Oh. I don't think Shannon can get no bigger.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
No, I ain't trying to get no bigger.
Yeah,
I'm trying to get healthier.
Yeah.
Okay, back to our regularly scheduled program here.
Yes.
The trade.
Yes.
Why did you go on record right away and say, I don't want my son in New Orleans?
Well, we don't want to live in the cold. And they already got a point guard over there. They already got some things.
They don't have a point guard.
Well, who? I say they do.
But
they got a couple of guys, but
guards.
Phoenix, we don't like living in the cold.
Okay.
My boys, we don't like living in the cold.
So is it about the city of New Orleans?
You ain't gonna be little. You say you gonna stay out in Chino.
We, as in my family, you know where I'm at right now? Where? Cleveland.
It's cold.
Man, I was in the Arctic blast. You know what the Arctic blast is?
Yeah, I know about the vortex.
Well, God, I learned about it the other day. My eyeballs froze. I couldn't even open my eyes. But going like that, I'm not in that one hit or quitter thing. I'm thinking of Phoenix like this. If you get Lonzo, get Jello, get Melo.
For Phoenix. Okay.
For Phoenix. Okay. For Phoenix. On the fact that. I'm not trying to just go in there and play. I'm trying to build a dynasty.
Okay, so you're going to the worst team in the
West. The worst team. They can't do nothing but go up.
Okay.
But they got to listen and let's go play our way. My boys is winners, man.
Okay.
And like I said, the Lakers turn them into losers.
Okay, but remember, New Orleans at point guard's got Elfrid Payton and Tim Frazier and Frank Jackson.
Those are some point guards.
Huh?
Those are point guards over there.
But you can play your son better.
I'm saying you can't compete.
I believe my son better than them.
Okay, well then show me.
What? Show you? I got to go there? I'm going to show you in Phoenix. The sun rises over there.
It does. Your son would
my
rise
My son
over
would
there.
Take that thing. And here's the thing. You can't do it by yourself. That's why I'm in the building, a dynasty where you bring my other two boys. They never worry about leaving. And just before things take off, how you beat the Lakers and you had a number two pick multiple times and before something can jump off and nobody's done anything.
Okay, so hypothetically,
yes.
Let's just do this. If your son goes with Kuzma and Ingram and Zubats and, you know, whatever to New Orleans.
Right.
That's a pretty good nucleus. Do you not trust those other kids to rise with your son?
Here's the thing. Those other kids are going to rise with my son. Whoever plays with my son is going to go up.
Okay.
The fact that Lonzo's not playing now, them players you thought was good ain't that good. It ain't like this is new. The same thing happening. How many players you hear about at UCLA right now? TJ, Leafs, EK, whatever. You don't hear about none of them guys because Lonzo's not there to make them look as good as they are. Brandon Ingram struggling. Hart struggling, Kuzma struggling, they all going to struggle if Lonzo ain't in the picture.
Is it possible that when you declared, I don't want my son down there in New Orleans, that you blew the trade up?
Well, if the trade blow up, oh well. I'm just letting you know
you
we don't want to be there.
You torpedoed the trade on purpose?
Oh, no. Why? If it's torpedo, you got a lot of players to choose from. My son ain't that good. That's what they say. So take them other guys and go and do your thing. But he must be a big part. And well, like people say,
I think this is normal
where people say, you know what? Everybody gets traded and going their way. And you say the same thing. Lavar don't say nothing. He can't say nothing. I don't mean nothing. I can say what I want to put in other people's head to let them know. We don't want to be there. If I don't want to be there, don't take that guy. That's like having a girl and you say, oh, she's always pretty. But you can't make her love you. She says she want to go the other way. You can bring her over there. But
if it's an arranged marriage in the Middle East, you can.
Who going to the Middle East?
It's a arranged marriage. They already over there.
They see you over there messing. They get 4 or 5 women.
So if you hear coming up at 3 o'clock Eastern noon here that your son has been traded to New Orleans, what are you going to do about it?
What am I going to do about it? You got to go over there. But you can't make him play.
So would he sit?
He going to do whatever he want to do, but you can't.
No, I hear what he want to do. No, you over there talking. I ain't heard him say that. You talking.
You ain't going to hear nothing because he don't want to talk to you because he know how you are against me. So I tell him,
No, don't talk to that boy.
He negative on us. No. Skip, speak up.
Thank you.
No.
Thank you.
You very negative.
No, you know.
I know you negative.
My problems with you.
See, and there you go.
As being a parent and having a son that's on a team and being hypocritical of said players and coach of that team. And what that ain't no negativity.
And what did your grandmama tell you?
Just because you can speak it doesn't mean you should.
If I can speak it, I'm going. You know what? You listen to your grandmama a lot. But you ain't listen to your grandfather at all. I ain't never heard you say it.
I talk about it.
Get on outside sometime, man. Stop standing over there sitting on the rocking chair with your grandma all the time.
No. You, Lavar, now you know it. If you was a coach and another parent's kid was on your roster and they criticizing your sons or they're criticizing you, you're not going to take kindly to that, Lavar, because you don't take kindly to criticism now.
Do you?
I understand.
Stop stuttering. Of course you don't.
As an athlete, you don't take no criticism. Lavar.
You don't take no criticism.
Yes, I do.
No, you
As being an athlete,
I've
come on,
heard
Lavar.
Skip criticize you many a times and you still getting loud. Because you're mad.
No, Lavar, you know it. Yes. You played in the NFL.
Okay.
You know criticism comes along with being an athlete.
So why are we worried about this? If I'm criticizing somebody, why are we worried about this? I'm going to criticize.
Why?
When things go bad, I always criticize. I don't sit there and just take it.
Hold on. But see, you keep saying it's Luke Walton. It's this one.
Tell me it ain't Luke Walton.
Hold on. Wait a minute.
Tell me it ain't Luke Walton. No, I just want to hear you say that. Say it ain't Luke Walton.
I dare you to say that. Hold on.
Because you know what's right.
Hold on, Lavar. You keep saying it's Luke Walton, it's this one and that one.
Right.
Does Lonzo bear any culpability in this?
No. You know why? Here's the thing. Let Lonzo do what he do. Let him win.
That's not how a team works, Lavar.
Why don't it work?
You don't get to go on there and say it's been working like that
for the last few years.
What y'all winning? What they win at UCLA?
He went to the Sweet 16.
They don't hang banners for that UCLA.
He won 30-something games.
They don't hang banners for that
he
UCLA.
He won 30-something games. He won 30. You know what I told him?
What?
I'm going to tell you what I'm telling him. I'm going to break it down. Lonzo don't have no excuses about nothing.
I know he doesn't.
Listen to me. Son, go get that championship at UCLA. Go get it. He on his way to get it. Listen to me. He on his way to get it. But he can't get it.
Why?
You know why? Because somebody on our side texts Lonzo something to get him out of his mind. And the text had to deal with his mom. Mm. You don't know what's going on. But he ain't going to say nothing because this is the way I bred him. So
why would somebody do that, though?
That's what I wonder. But I ain't going to go into that because I don't want the family thing to go upside down.
Right.
Which should have never been done because I was going to tell him. Mm. But his text in there.
Oh, so that's how he found out.
He found out.
Okay.
If he thinking.
Yeah.
A regular kid thinking his mom's going to die the next day?
Right.
How you going to come back from that?
Right.
I told you
so
yesterday.
So then I had to go and redo things. I said, son, go do what you got to do.
Right.
I got her.
Right.
Let me, man. But my boys ain't like, oh, man, I can't do it. They're not going to do that. They're just going to fly forward. And that's what caused them. But you don't put that out there like that. You know, you played the game, but he's still young. Never had been in that situation. I said, son, do what you're going to do, man. Get your ass over there and play. But I got her. She's going to be fine.
Right.
And you did not go.
Man, I didn't go to that thing. No, I think I'm not going to see my son.
I know.
But I have to do like this.
You got
to go
priority,
here.
Right.
Or I go here.
Right.
And it's important, but mama's way more important.
By the way, he took that team with T.J. Leaf, and they went to Kentucky, and they beat them at Kentucky.
They beat them before, but when your mind ain't right,
right.
and you're thinking about other things, there's no way you can perform like that.
What about
that's the thing.
What about the unrealistic expectations?
What do you mean by the unreal? Here's the thing. Unrealistic expectations make us the big baller. How do you come into a league with your own brand? You know anybody going to say, it's never been done before. Why? Because the expectation is so high, you're not even going to approach that.
I heard something you said yesterday. You said Luke Walton has turned my son
into a loser.
Hold on, Skip.
Into a loser.
Okay. You can be on a team and lose but not be a loser. I'm a firm believer losing is a mindset.
Okay, you got it. He got a great mindset of losing, Luke Walton. Been losing for 3 years. Great mindset for losing.
Man, but look.
Now, you tell me this. You're talking about, Lonzo is a winner. Go to Summer League, and I know you're going to say Summer League is just Summer League. But what's the difference between Summer League and the pros? On the fact that...
Because a lot of them guys...
Okay, the coach did a heck of a job. How does Lonzo get MVP without even playing the last game? Because the coach who's doing the Summer League, Lonzo, go on, do what you do. Get these triple-doubles, have fun, do what you do.
But how many of those...
Winning, staying in the game, who cares? Hold on. He going to get the championship because that's what he made for. And then when the season starts, starting him, playing 4 or 5 minutes, pull him out no matter what. Sit him down for 12 minutes.
I disagree with that.
Sit him down for 12 minutes.
No, he didn't do that.
But when he played in that Phoenix game, when he's balling out of control, guess what? We ain't pulling him back and forth. Let him go.
That was his second
game. That was his second game. Then he loose. He's like, man, okay. But then you don't play him and start him in the fourth quarter. How do you think he's feeling about that? If he'd been playing the whole game his whole life.
Right.
His whole life he'd been like this. Let me go get these wins. Mm. And you don't believe in him like that? Mm. Man, come on, man. Now I'm just going to go to work and do what you want me to do and just whatever.
No, you can't have that attitude.
And here's the mindset.